So your knee pain is less than 3 weeks old. You're not having severe swelling, locking, or giveaway in the knee. Almost overwhelmingly, the likelihood is that you have a sprain. A sprain of the knee is where force has been applied or something happened that was more than the tissues of the knee could handle, but nothing broke, thank goodness. These sprains are going to get better on their own with time, but there are some things you can do which really makes them go away enormously faster. And this is, I always think it sounds kind of German, but this is Rice Nsaid. Rice, R-I-C-E, Nsaid, N-S-A-I-D. Let's start with the rice. R stands for rest. Look, you need to get up and go to the bathroom. Some movement and some weight on your knee is going to be inevitable. But if you don't have to do that movement right now, skip it. I stands for ice. Cold has an anti-inflammatory effect on tissue. So you want to get ice on the joint the best you can. Some people have used a frozen bag of peas, or there are commercially available ice packs, which are really, really nice. How much should you ice? As much as feels good. As a general rule, put the ice pack on when it's no longer super cold, put it back in the freezer, and when it's super cold again, put it back on. It's really good to combine the ice with the C, which is compression. A neoprene sleeve brace, which you can easily get at a Walgreens or a CVS or order on Amazon, is a really effective way of getting compression around the knee. This has two parts that are really good. The pressure helps keep swelling down, feels good, but also gives you a little extra strength. A neoprene sleeve is a very different brace from an unloader. You don't want the kind of commercial braces that a doctor would prescribe that take all of the force off the knee. We want to get some range of motion and keep you going. And then the last is E, which stands for elevate. You want to keep your knee up a little bit. A lot of people actually find it more painful to elevate. If it hurts, don't do it. You want to baby that knee during this stage of your recovery. So use your common sense. The next part is the NSAID, N-S-A-I-D. It's another acronym, and it stands for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. And although it's a crazy term you may never have heard, I guarantee you've heard of an NSAID because Motrin is an NSAID, ibuprofen. Motrin is 200 milligrams. People will often say, well, can you prescribe it so we can get the 800 milligrams? Sure, but it's actually just 4 of the 200 milligrams. It's the exact same thing. Aleve is kind of nice because it's twice a day versus the Motrin, which is 3 times a day. Which is better for you? Well, the one that works the best. And there's no telling. Sometimes you just have to get both at the drugstore and see which works best for you. But you don't take both. You take one or the other because they work on the same mechanism. Well, what about prescription NSAIDs? Yeah, there's a lot of medications like Celebrex. Celebrex was devised to try to reduce the acid that is naturally produced by NSAIDs, stomach acid. It may or may not, it turns out, do that very well, but it's a little bit of a different mechanism. So Celebrex may be something you should ask your doctor for. It does require a prescription. If there's one that works for you, take that one. The last thing I really do want to caution you on, though, is the stomach acid. If you have a history of ulcers or reflux, then do not take NSAIDs, any anti-inflammatory, without first getting clearance from your doctor. If you don't have a history of ulcers, it's going to make acid anyway. Let's not get an ulcer. So if you're taking NSAIDs, I want you to take, to protect your stomach, an antacid with it. Either take something like Pepcid Complete, which is really just Pepcid plus Tums, or Prilosec, P-R-I-L-O-S-E-C. Prilosec is over-the-counter, it's once a day, and it'll really reduce the risk that you have an acid ulcer as a result of the NSAID. Well, this is the end of our interactive video series for you. I hope your pain is gone by the end of 3 weeks since the pain began through the Rice Nsaid type of approach. In the event that it's not, go back and start again, and we'll move you on to the next appropriate video for you. Good luck.